So I will stop presenting, sir. You please, shall I?
Yeah, okay. I will take the presentation. Okay. Okay. So everybody can see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So everyone can see the screen. So who asked the question? It is Nitin Sai, isn't it?
Yes, sir. You can
proceed. Okay. For everybody else, like Nitin Sai asked some information about JDBC different driver types. Okay. So I will try to explain him. And everybody else also can listen to it. Actually, what he said is like he could understand type 1 and he understood type 4 as well. Nitin Sai, isn't it? Okay. These two are clear to you because they are pretty straightforward actually. For all the databases, like you have the ODBC connectivity. So basically like open database connectivity, they all will provide that API and then like JDBC, ODBC bridge will basically do the translation from JDBC to ODBC. Okay. And you use Windows ODBC to built-in set drivers. This should be very clear to you. Then the point is, okay, if there is no ODBC, for example, okay, and then like say, for example, like every database has an API, okay, every database vendor will have their own native way of calling their SQL statement, isn't it? Okay. If that is the case, basically this type 2 driver will do is like it will take the JDBC and it will convert to the calls of these native SQL calls directly. Okay, now is it clear? So it will take the JDBC, instead of converting it into ODBC, it will directly convert into vendor specific, vendor native SQL calls directly. Okay, so that is about type 2 driver. Whereas type 3 driver is, it's a network driver. Basically, it translates the JDBC to a DBMS independent network protocol. So basically something like a middleware, okay? So what it will do is like, it will take the JDBC calls, it will basically convert them to whatever the middleware product basically accepts, okay? So the middleware may basically accept have its own API and this driver basically will convert this JDBC into that third party middleware specific API calls. And then like the third party will actually route the calls to these databases. So that's about type 3 driver. Type 4 is again pretty much clear, okay? So it takes the JDBC and it directly makes the API calls of the respective RDBMS. Not even SQL calls, but directly API calls of RDBMS. This is about type 4 driver. Now is it clear? Nitin Sai? Yeah. It's related to a third, okay. So product related to server side, yes. So there can be third party services which actually can support that one. But sometimes like, okay, I mean like immediately we can't give you an example, but the idea is like the third party middleware. Yeah, let's be straightforward. The answer to your question is like it can be from server side, okay? That's the easiest way. So if the server fails, the connection cannot be established. On the other way, like if the middleware fails, the connection cannot be established. Okay. In this course, like we are not discussing about all those architectures and then like web services, MOM protocols and all those things. Okay. But you are right. Okay. If the middleware fails, connection cannot be established. Actually, you should not be thinking it in terms of non-reliability. Say, for example, any server fails, you have no connection. Whatever may be the server, say, for example, why you only think about DBMS server? You think about like, say, for example, University of HYD, uohyd.ac.in. If the server is down, uohyd.ac.in website is gone, okay? That you cannot call it as non-reliable, okay? So that's not the basic idea. Actually, it is to increase the robustness itself. These sort of middleware solutions are actually to load balance and to actually increase the robustness. Say, for example, like a company can have multiple database servers. Okay. Say, for example, it can have its own like SQL server, MySQL server, and then some other server, and Oracle, and then so on. So multiple servers, if the it has these services. And then like your applications, say, for example, your recommendation system will go to one of the servers. And say, for example, some other analysis server will go to a database analytics server, something from Oracle, okay? And say, for example, some other service, like you have to approach a MySQL server. Then like if your client application has to take care of that one, it need to have the access to all these three or four types of different drivers, isn't it? Which in certain cases is not ideal. Okay, it all depends on the application, what the company is actually developing. Okay. So your third statement, it is highly reliable. Actually, the purpose is to basically load balance it. So it is actually highly robust. Okay, so it is exactly opposite to what probably you were assuming. Is it clear now? Okay, agreed. To give you the hint, like, you know, like most of the application servers, okay, what is the guarantee that, what is the amount of availability that they have to guarantee? Say something like, if you establish a server on Amazon, you know, what is the probability, what is the guarantee level of service provisioning that they have to give? Any idea? Okay, right. They have to basically guarantee 5 9s. They should be up and running 99.999 times, or else like they will basically fail the service level agreements. Okay. And then like it will be a huge problem. So most of these services are extremely stable, to give you the answer. Say, for example, if you establish a server, okay, if Amazon provides you a server and you have your website running on that Amazon server, so for example on the cloud server, whatever it is, the server should be up and running 99.999 times, 5 9s, most often. That is the service level agreement they have to guarantee. So forget about those 0.5s and 0.25s. If it is 0.25 probability of the server running, then literally you will have zero clients. Understood?
Let me add points here. Hello.
Yeah, I can hear you, Nagendra.
Just to augment the answer, Nitin Sai, are you online?
Yeah, he's typing. So that means he's online. So he is putting answers in the chat box.
Okay.
Just I was answering to his questions actually. One after the other, he was asking.
Okay, sir. So please, I will go to the presentation mode, sir. Can you please?
Okay. I will stop presentation. Right. I stopped.
Okay, so to continue with that ODB, JDBC drivers, there are, of course, you might have seen that there are four different types of drivers. So your doubt is on type 2 and type 3, right, Nitin? Is it the doubt related to type 2 and type 3? Yes. So type 2 is basically API drivers. So API means, what is the meaning of API driver? API stands for, Nitin, can you, if you don't mind, can you answer, or others, you can also join. So what does API stands for? Application Programming Interface. Very good. So Now I am just presenting on my screen. Now, so far we have seen the PHP MySQL interconnection. So let me open the program to you, some simple program. Okay, let me just show you this statement. MySQLi query. Here you have something called MySQL underscore connect. Okay. So on the left of my screen, I have highlighted a statement here. Connect is equal to MySQLi underscore connect. So what does this statement represent? MySQLi underscore connect statement. Nitin, can you please answer? What is that MySQLi underscore connect? MySQLi underscore connect, you can call it as an instruction or simply you can call it as a statement using a built-in PHP function. Okay, it is a method. It is a function. Very good. So I can call it as a function. I can call it as a statement. Statements means SQL statement. We call it as SQL, structured query language statement, or you can call it as a command or a function or a method. All means the same. So your built-in PHP function, this MySQL underscore connect, is basically your API driver only. In fact, your API, this is one of the API call. So as you see in the type one, you need to connect to your particular DBC, database connectivity. So instead of making connection to your database connectivity with your native databases or with something called a database, here we are using a function here. That's what your MySQL underscore connect. So if you see the literature, if you go to the websites of MySQL PHP, PHP MySQL Connect API. Okay, these are called application programming interfaces. See, the MySQL documentation gives you what is an API, application programming interface. So here we are using these connectors and you are using something called drivers. So here the driver, you call it as PHP data objects, PDO. Equivalent to this PDO is your MySQL underscore connect only. So let me show you the different types of drivers and the PSQLi connect. Instead of wandering you in on the entire documentation, let me not confuse you here. Just hold on. I'll just type. This is an example for MySQL Connect.
But Nagendran, just I mean, like his question was about JDBC drivers.
So but the type 2 is asking for a difference between type 2 and type 3. So what I am giving is this example, MySQL Connect is
MySQL Connect is type 2 driver, basically.
Yes, yeah. It is a type 2 driver. That's what I was trying to, because already they might have practiced on MySQL underscore connect method. So you have to inform that this is a one type of your JDBC driver only, which is equivalent to JDBC driver is your MySQL Connect, which is basically a type 2. So that point I would like to get it. I want to show them on the documentation. If you can just browse the documentation, you'll get that particular information clearly. Just hold on for 1 minute. I will just get back to you. Okay, now see here, Nitin Sai. See, there are three MySQL APIs. There are three different types. One is your PDO. The other one is your MySQL Connect, that statement which you are using now. And there is simply creating an object, and that object is querying to select that particular statement. So here, if you see, these are called basically type 2 drivers, MySQL APIs. These are basically your API, the native these call it as native application programming interface drivers. So these are basically your type 2. You can get more information from this documentation, Nitin. Yeah. So yeah, coming to our let us go to that other point. This regarding to our assessment procedure for the practicals and examination, in continuation to the last week discussion, please. So last week we have given you some of the instructions. So if you go to our course page today, you can go to our course page, Internet Technologies Course Evaluation. This is final. Last week we have put open, means we have discussed with you, and we have kept it open for further discussions. And so far nobody has come up with any objection or some kind of corrections. So this is updated on today's date. I kept it the today's date also. So you can download it. And once you download, you'll see this is the document which has been updated. So we have come down to that assignments evaluation average of, instead of 10, we have come down to 6. That's what we agreed in the last discussion. And similarly, coming to this integrated MTech lab practicals, the remaining things are for the MCAs and integrated MTech regarding the theory, theory part is going to be the common for you all. The mini project I'm going to discuss with you, the guidelines, what is the procedure we follow to evaluate that submission of the mini project case studies. So in continuation to this, we have put some material to you. All of you, please go through this as very short material, but very important. And it gives you a lot of insights on designing and developing your web applications. So here, what are the key? When I say key means important here. Of course, these are not the only things, but very important things that you need to keep in mind when you're designing a website or a web application. In fact, simply a website too. So just go through this one, and you can further refer to this on these particular links to get more information on whatever I mentioned the points over here. So I just bulleted some of those key important points. Now coming to, please all of you, please focus here. Try to just means those who are on the session, please have an important point to be considered here. The web application or the website should be publicly accessible, and the source code should be downloadable from GitHub. Submit the hyperlinks as part of the submission of the assignment. So all MCA students and integrated MTech students, what are the tasks you are submission to for this particular course evaluation procedures? That is, for one particular task is on the mini project, and the other two major tasks are related to the integrated MTech students. All your programming codes must be available on your GitHub links. The source code should be downloadable from your GitHub links, and your websites or web application, whatever you are designing and developing, should be made publicly. Means I should be able to access your website. So how do you run those things, and how do you make those things to be publicly available on your running from your own laptop? These points I told you some time back also. Again, I will giving you that instruction. So in the next Friday's class, once your small exercises which are completed on assignment 3, basically, once some web pages are ready with you and you're almost able to complete your assignment 4, so a part of your website is ready with you, a partially a website is you have designed yourself with some web pages. So once that particular websites are partially available for you, then you can make it publicly available. So how do you do that? That particular demonstration, I will give it to you on Friday session. So please be ready with your, whatever the web pages, at least three or four web pages, which are you have done based on assignment 3 and assignment 4, keep it ready for your Friday's class. So that demo, how you can make it accessible through your www, you'll see it. So this is regarding one important point. Now coming to the MCIN Integrated MTech, the 30 marks, how their 30 marks are being categorized, or you can see divided into various solutions of that particular problem which you are going to do it. So you have to design and develop a web application of your choice for MCIN Integrated MTech for the, or that is a major assignment which is carrying around 30 marks. So please decide among yourself, and please mention those problem statements on our announcement sections of the course page, so that other students will not opt for this. So whoever does enter that particular information, like if you go to your course pages here, I'm just showing an example here. If you go to your integrated something like a lab here, so you get task one, this is the one problem statements are there. So once you can, something you can enter here. So you need to enter your problem statement here. All the students who are, this is related to Integrated MTech, around 20 students, they can access this particular box here. They can just enter with your name, with your ID number, or with your name. Preferably your ID number is better instead of names. So you just enter your name, number, your ID number, something like whatever, MC, something like this. And you are going to say something like student management system or student attendance system or whatever you like to have it, or your library management system, or your whatever the web application that you like to do it, that you please enter here. So once you enter here in this announcement section for this task one, this student has reserved that particular problem and he is going to solve it and he is going to submit it. And the other students, please do not take the same problem statement again. So that should be avoided. That is an important point here. So no repetitions here. That's what the meaning. Repetition of the problem statement is not permitted. Hence, students can inform the selection of the problem statement in the announcement section of the course page. For task one, it will be separate announcements will be there. Task two, separate announcements. For your major assignments or for the 30 marks, it will be separate announcements. So please mention your, on the three different places, you can mention your respective problems that you are going to see. So the first point that you are going to consider for evaluation is you have to create a home page or an index page along with 4 other web pages. So those 4 other web pages will be based on the application which you are going to put forward, in the sense that whatever the functionalities that you want to incorporate into your website, those functionalities will be reflecting on your those 4 web pages. So that 4 web pages, whatever the elements that you want to put it on the web pages, you need to design accordingly and you need to plan it properly to disseminate that information on the respective 4 web pages. So totally there will be 5 web pages of that, at least a minimum of those things. Now, effective use of color, images and fonts and proper markup language, page markup languages, links. The proper page markup language means your basically your hyperlinks and meta links should be there in your web application. That constitutes to 5 marks. Now you may be using your HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or other programming language features, or with respect to PHP, or with respect to your JSP, or any other server side languages. It's up to you. So again, that also constitutes its implementation. That constitutes to 5 marks. So as part of that major assignments, it's not that the website is fully functional. It means you are not going to design and develop a complete big picture. It means it looks like a big picture that you are going to develop it, but it need not be a fully functional. All 5 pages functionality need not be required, but at least the links you need to provide it and make sure those, when the user clicks those links, appropriate elements without their functionalities are going to be reflected or going to be shown on those respective web pages. Now, some of the interactive features should be functional. some of the interactive features means where the user is able to enter some data in some of the text boxes, or you are going to see some of those outputs, whatever the entered data is there, some calculations which comes out of from the JavaScripts. Those some kind of interactive features should be there on that particular web pages. So that constitutes to 5 marks. Please make sure that user registration, if there are new users which you are trying to access your web application, there's a new user registration. Authentication means whether those registered users are only accessing those websites or not. You need to provide that authentication mechanism along with the page or a form validation features across the different website, means across the different web pages, should be functional. It means it should be working. The working code, the application should be live for these particular set of features. So that constitutes to 5 marks. And also important things such as insertions, deletions, updations, and search operations. Whenever you are going to search some items on your web pages, so like your Google search, whenever you try to enter some characters, automatically there is some kind of intelligence, some matching words are going to be shown to you. That is basically a search operation which is happening there with the help of some AJAX feature. That what is AJAX and all, we are going to discuss it here. So these are the minimum things. Insertions, inserting the new, if suppose you are developing e-commerce or a student website or an employee, any kind of application that you are going to develop, there will be some kind of insertions, adding new values, new products, new users, something like the deletions with the existing users or changing some existing values, updations, and trying to search it from the websites. It can be users or it can be products which you are going to display it on the websites. So those must be functional here. So that constitutes to 5 marks. So all these two constitutes to around 30 marks of your major assignment. So in addition to these things, for integrated MTech students, this is in addition to these above 6 points. There are other things that you need to take care of, at least to a maximum extent, such that your code is going to be a very valid code for you. So the first 3 to 4 points, the 3 points remains the same for you. And coming to the fourth point, on your website for integrated MTech students, for both the task one and task two, you have to provide something like contact and inquiry forms. Those inquiry things can be done along with providing a small online chat service application. So on your web application, you are going to put some online chat feature also. These things need to be done. So if you can complete on the task one and task two, then only you will be awarded the 5 marks for that particular thing. And also for integrated MTech students, please make sure that your HTML code is a proper validation is being done. So how do you check whether whatever the code you have written is a properly written code, is following the principles of W3 consortium or not? So if you can go to this website, that is validated.w3.org. So this is the markup validation service. Something like, suppose if I type that https://learn1.uh4d.ac.in. So I'm checking whether this website, whether this application is following the HTML standards or not. So when I click that the URL and when I click the check button, so now it says the document was successfully checked against the XHTML 1.0 transitional. So it says that at least it has passed the HTML standard. So it is following the encoding UTF. If the document type is HTML, XHTML, the dynamic one. So like this, you need to get your document to be successfully checked by this particular markup validation service. So whatever the application you develop, so here, how do you check it? Means, see, you can upload your source code to this by choosing the file, and you can check it. Instead of if your file means you are not running your website, you can as well upload your code and check whether it is a validation is done or not. So the integrated MTech students, please, this particular activity also should be completed for task one and task two. So that is one thing that constitutes to 5 marks. Yes, similarly to the earlier task, registration, authentication, it should be done. But for integrated MTech students in this task one and task two, there is a small additional features need to be incorporated. So there are different types of users who are going to log into your web application. Something the user like an admin should have a different privileges, different features should be there. for a normal user, different set of functionalities, different set of hyperlinks, different set of elements can be shown. So that kind of distinction between should be there between an admin user and a normal user. That feature should also be, you should take care of this part for this particular item. So whatever that links and elements you are keeping on your website should all should be functional. Nothing should be just clicking the link and nothing is going to be shown like that. Please do avoid. Whatever the hyperlinks you provide and whatever the elements that you provide should be functional. And along with this, with the insertion, deletion, updation, search, for integrated MTA students, there are other two features you should look into. You can upload your picture files, like your photographs. If a student registration application you are doing, you should, your picture should be uploaded onto your database and you should be downloadable also. Not only your picture files, you can put some multimedia video files, something like that. And also you need to take care of the alerts. Alert means based on something, some user is trying to access something. Well, you can put some features in this one. So all this constitutes, this requires your Ajax, jQuery, and JSON features. This constitutes to 10 marks. So as mentioned in the last interactive meeting, of course, I just kept it aside AI and ML language features. I'm afraid people will not be very much interested on that one. That's why I just taken out the AI and ML features to be done, incorporating the methods. Those students who are interested for them, how do we put AI and ML with your JavaScript, then I can give a demo for 1 or 2 days or for 1 or 2 hours lectures. And they can at least appreciate and try to understand how AI and ML can be incorporated in the JavaScript. Only for those students who are interested, I can give some demo. Otherwise, you can, the others, it is up to you. You just at least you need to complete. These are the minimum things that will definitely make you gain confidence in this particular web applications or the mobile apps that you are going to design and develop in the future for your career purpose. Yeah, I'm at a stretch I was continuously talking. Any doubts here, please, so far? I hope at least you are you able to follow what I have mentioned in this particular assessment procedure. If you have any doubts, you can just put forward now, no problem. Hello. Okay. Tarun has put some question. Sir, user authentication, admin logins, and all are mandatory. Like it depends on the individual project ID, you know, sir. Yes, of course. See, any project or any application that you do it, Tarun, basically the application has got users will be different. It's not that only one set of users always will be accessing. So there will be different types of users. So as an web administrator, or you can, of course, there will be different people. Web developer is different. As a normal user is a different. Web administrator is a different. Each user has a different set of privileges. It's not that everybody is equal in this website. Suppose if you take the example of our SEIS Learn Moodle website. So here, an admin user has got different rights, different privileges. So he has got different features to be used for that. As a student, as a student, you have different privileges. As a teacher, your teacher will have different privileges. It's not that all users have the same set of privileges. That's why user authentication, admin logins is a must. User authentication is a must for any user. Only valid users are able to access those websites. And admin logins will have additional features to manage and control the website properly. So definitely there will be, it is a mandatory, yes. It does not depend on individual project, no. So please develop your application for admin user, what privileges you can decide, what rights the admin user has got and what rights the normal user has got. You can decide on your own. Yeah, Tarun, is it clear? Okay, right, fine. Yeah, any other doubts, please? So all the instructions have been put on the course page. Please go through it. The entire evaluation is done. I mean, evaluation procedure is also been made available to you now. Sir, what about chat box? Chatbox, see here, similar to chatbox, I asked you to keep here. One particular is on the something like, see, whenever you try to have chat conversation with the company people or to the web website, you have something here. Definitely there should be some kind of real-time query answerings. So you can put a bot, B-O-T. So you can put a bot application there, or I don't want to make you confused here, or you can have something like an online chat feature, very simple online chat feature also can be put. Instead of a chat box, which has got more features, you can just put simply request and reply kind of feature can be incorporated in your online chat. Instead of a file uploading, file downloadings, and other features need not be there for the chat boxes. Like your WhatsApp chat box, you need not have all the features over there, but at least some request in terms of text request and in terms of reply that you get it from your admin of that particular website, something like that you can get. Is it clear, Nitin? Yeah. MCS students, sir, please assignment 4 discuss once. Okay. Coming to assignment 4, let me just open the file. Hold on. Okay, assignment 4 is on PHP MySQL cookies. So assignment 4 is this. So coming to line by line, I'm just trying to explain to you. Please listen to this assignment 4. Give appropriate title to each web page. You know how to give a title for your web pages. Title tag itself is the minimum important thing required. Format web pages with appropriate background color, text color, images, etc. That's what this is, one of the design feature that is required for every web page. That's why again, once again, I'm reiterating today that particular point. What are the design features that you need to look for? These are the important design features. Once I have given in terms of very key points. So whenever you design your website, please make sure that these are the important points. What is the purpose of your website? Why exactly we need to develop it? What is your objective of your website? What you want on our website to convey? You must know who will be the users of your website. While designing on your website, you need to sketch your website on your some pages. You please sketch it yourself. What elements should be there on the website? How do you navigate from one web page to another web page? How do you depict the functionalities of your user requirements? So users must be able to surf the website quickly and easily. These are all important things. So here on every page, the text and the images are arranged in the form of a grid. It should not be like a cluttered, it should not be like a disordered manner. So you need to make sure that those pages are properly structured. And there should be a navigation. Navigation means from the home page, you should go to your shop page or from your to your blog page or to your frequently asked questions page or to your contact us page or from contact us page to go to another page very easily and understandably. So these are all the things that you need to look for carefully. That's why we kept some points for your designing the web pages with effect to proper colors, images, and the fonts and your markup links. That's why these also constitute some 5 marks. So when in this assignment also, the assignment 4 also says the same thing, format those web pages. When I say format, means properly structure those web pages. So formatting can be applied other than mentioned in the question. If required, if you please, especially in the question, if there's nothing is there, you please format according to whatever you think you require for you. So you are required to submit the codes scripts, whatever the scripts you read, and the screen prints related to the output file of the web pages as a single file. So please listen here. This is the instruction given here as a single file with your ID number as a file name. In spite of telling these things, I will get back to one email what I have received yesterday or day before yesterday. So you people, you don't read the instructions here, what it is mentioned here. And you say that you submitted through your zip files or you have submitted separate files and all. And you say, is it required, sir? Again, you ask me. Really wondering what is that you happening with you all. Just read the instructions first properly for every assignment that you do. Now, in this assignment 4, it has been bold here. The text is bold means you need to look into this properly and it should be considered properly. Technologies such as HTML, CSS, JS, DOM, Apache, MySQL, and PHP features are to be considered in the design and development of these web applications. So in this assignment 4, you need to compulsorily follow these things. These are the minimum things. That's why we are putting some constraints here. So the code or the script should contain the comment section to describe the logic of the statements in the program. So what are the statements you write it in your program? Those statements should be little bit described. The logic of that particular statement should be described in the form of comments. So it need not be very elaborately. At least you express what is that logic of that statement, or why is that, what is that particular loop is doing, or a conditional statement is checking for what. Something like, you please put it in the comments and give your explanation. Assume relevant data or elements of the web page wherever it is required. Whenever you're designing and developing a web pages, sometimes the user requirements will not come at a time. In the initial stage only, all the requirements will not come. User requirements keep on changing during the evolution of your projects. So these principles you will learn in your software development courses. But anyway, just to make sure that whenever you are developing a web application or a website, some new ideas may come or some new features you want to have it on your own. That's what creativity is more important in these courses, please. Internet technologies, web applications, mobile applications, the creativity, the features, how do you want to, if we try to restrict the features here, we are killing your innovations and your creativity doesn't come to proper shape. So that's why we don't want to put all restrictions, and we want to keep your innovativeness and creativityness openly. You can put more features accordingly as you like it, but at least the major functionality, the big picture of that application should follow what we try to ask you to do. So this is an exercise. You will need to implement a basic registration and login system. You know what it means by basic registration? Registration. A user has to register themselves onto a particular website or onto a particular web application or onto a particular database system. So only the users, when they register, then only they'll be able to log in the future requirements. It means later, once the registration is successful, then the user can able to use the features of those web applications or the mobile app or the system itself. So without worrying about any styling issues. See, styling means those registration form and your login system, you should not go for any CSS styling. It means how that letter should look like and what size and all. You need not be very much there is no restriction on that particular set of issues. You will get practice with forms, sending requests, and working with a MySQL database. So this is an example. How do you design a form, a PHP HTML form? And how do you send that request to the server? And how that particular application is working with respect to the backend database. It means for the registration, the user's data has to be entered on the form of your web page. And the data, when the user submits it, that data will be transferred into your database. And the data will be stored in the database. So that's what your registration system. And in the login system, whenever user enters username and password, so that whatever the user has entered the username and password, that data is passed on to your server through your PHP script, and that is checked on the server to check whether the user is a registered user or not. If a registered user is there, then the authentication or the login is successful. So otherwise the login is unsuccessful. So this, how the login is successful and how the how it can be unsuccessful, this please look into my previous three video sessions. The last three video sessions are related to this, how you can check whether is the login successful or not. If it is successful, how to navigate to a home page. So these things I have given in the my previous demo, please. Some students will attend today in today's session and some students will not attend. Some students are not regular in attending it. So they may miss and they may, whenever they get out, you are trying to clarify acceptable. But please look into the previous videos also regularly so that you will not miss those discussions what has happened earlier. So now make the database connection. So in order to make the database connection, the database should have certain structure. The database is a collection of data. That collection of data is been in a structured manner. In a relational database management system, that relation is having a particular structure. That is what your table. The table is having, the table, you call it as a schema or a structure of a table. What is that structure can contain? So the structure contains the table name is, the name of the table is IT lab exercises, exercise users. That exercise users has got, the structure has got three fields. You can call it as fields or common means column names, or you can call it as attributes. These are called username, password, and phone. And the username should be designated as unique. It means the username should not be repeated. No two users will have the same username. So like your, no two users will have the same email ID. So like this, this it is a, what is called primary and what is called unique. You will learn more clearly about the database fundamentals in your database management system course. So, but here when I say unique means no repetition, it is one and only one value. So you need to create a database. The database name is IT lab. That is what you are select, and you have to select the IT lab database. And in that database, you need to create a table. So how do you create a database and how do you put a table into the database? The last three video sessions I have clearly shown to you with the database name called a sample and the user, table name called users. I have shown the last two, three video lectures, please. Okay, please go through it. You can first, you create your database at the back end. A database has got appropriate table here. So once you do that particular exercise, it means the backend data is ready for you to accept and store it. So now this is part one. You need to make this particular thing. So in PHP file, in a PHP file, you can use the include or require functions. Include, what is meant by include here? Like you are including a preprocessor file. So where you have what is called localhost, what is called your username, what is called the password, and what is the database that you select. So this again, in the in my video file, this include statement already I have given to you. So please go through my video file. If you don't mind, I can open and show you. Once this explanation is over, I'll show you that one. Now coming to part two, write the registration form. So this is what your registration form, the front end looks like. Note that all of this part should be done on the same PHP file. So a PHP file has got your HTML contents also. So if you look to my node, my material of PHP MySQL, where your PHP file and your, let me just wait, hold on, another student also is requesting this one. Okay, in the meantime, some questions are posted here on the chat. Kindly hold on with that questions. Yashaswini Rupa, okay, you're also online, right? So here I'm explaining about the PHP file onto the same, on the same file, you can write your front end page and the PHP code together. So that example, the notes which I given to you, let me just open to you and show you one second. Okay. So if you see my video, PHP MySQL user login system, that gives you the demo of how do you connect your MySQL. So the last two, three videos are about that only. Now coming to this particular point, the point here is write a PHP file that will output a form containing, note that all this part should be done in the same PHP file. See here, if you are the same PHP file, the example for this is this one. One such example here, very simple example here. You have the PHP script here, as well as you have the HTML script here. So both are in the same file only. So when you write a particular PHP with an HTML file, you can use this global reference variables of $get and $post from one web page to another web page. So in that particular web page, you can use this particular values using this global reference variable with the same HTML script on the same page. So this, you can go through this. Of course, I think I'm not given another example of your database itself here. Okay, this is another PHP file. This gives entirely the PHP, but without the HTML here. That PHP and HTML together, let me give you one example here instead of going through that. Just hold on. So this my site one and my site two, those examples are basically here. So here, this is what your include file is. So include method. Just now I told you, these are the examples which you have seen in the previous video sessions. So this is basically the entirely PHP file here, or the login system. The authentication system here. Authentication means whether it is a successful login or not. I'm not having that particular PHP and HTML code together, but I do remember that particular files are there with me, and I've given some examples. So yeah, something like this, please. See here carefully, in the same form, HTML code is there here, and a PHP script is also there here. So this is what you can get it in the same form here. This is one such example here. So where you have a form element, the form action part is there here, and a part of that particular PHP code here. So this is what your PHP code. Because this particular code has to run on the server side. Whenever you see this PHP tags, means it implies that the following set of lines are going to be run on your server. And whenever you see just simply this particular HTML tags, it means they are basically running on your client side. They are not running on the server side. This is one example, running your PHP and HTML on the same page. Let me open one more example. Okay, this is another example. Please see here, all of you. So this is also a PHP with HTML only on the same page. So something like you are connecting to your database. This is your MySQL connection statements. You are getting the username and password. So of course, this is basically along with the sessions. So when the session is there, you can come back. Once this is particular thing is valid, so here on the form, you have just only the form entering the details of the user that is written in the HTML form tag, entering the username and the password. And once the user enters the username and password and clicks the submit button. So once the user clicks the submit button, what happens is that submit button is going to run that particular, whatever the values that the user has entered. So that user has entered, this is what the dollar post username. So the dollar post is basically a global reference variable. Whatever the username, this username is a element name that you can get it from your HTML only here. This is what your HTML tag, the username input. Similarly, the password. These are basically your HTML tags only. And remember, both the things are written on the same PHP file. This is the name of the PHP file. So this username and password, this is the things that are, you can access those elements names with the help of your dollar underscore post. That's what I was telling just before. So you can use this global reference variables dollar post. Similarly, you can use dollar get also. You know the difference between dollar get and dollar post, basically the security purpose. So here both the values have been given as values to this SQL statement. So that is select star from login, that is the data table name is login user, where username is this and the password is whatever the user is entered. If it is there, then you just display the user is existing. Otherwise, invalid username and password. Without session also, the same program will run. This is only just to keep that sessions will enable us to, like your admin user, the admin user is there, the same session gets the different values. So this is one good example to have the PHP and HTML along with the sessions in the same example. This is one set of. So this is what your index.php, you can set up both HTML and PHP on the same page. Are you getting this point, Ashwini? Yes, yeah. So I have just shown you one example. I don't want to give the same file to you all because you can just simply copy and write. You can write on your own file those things. Once your assignment date is over, then I can post those particular sample codes, whatever I have, so that you can refer it back. So let me just complete that assignment four discussion. Where are we?
Nagendra, just a joke. In the video, they have the source code.
What happened, sir?
In the video, they have the source code.
Ah, okay. At least let them refer it, sir. Let them refer
it. Okay.
No problem. Let them at least try to do on there.
Okay.
Sir, I'll call you back in after 1 hour. I'm on a class now. I'll call you back after 1 hour. So this is what it is given here. Write a PHP file, that output containing three fields, username, password, and a phone number here. Clearly giving three different fields here. These fields should be sent as via post to the same file. Just now I given the example to you, how the dollar underscore post can be used to represent on the same file, which should means which should take care of inserting them into the database. What are the database and the table that just now you created before this part two is being created. So in the same file, whatever I just shown you here, here we are using the select statement instead of this select statement. Here you can see the SQL statement select. Instead of this one, you're going to use insert table name values. You know what is that insert statement syntax is. So that statement is going to be executed here. That's what this example is about. So you need to store your username, password, and the phone numbers onto the database till, you know, if the username already exists, your insert query should fail. That means username should be unique. That's why we told that username cannot be repeated. That's what you show that username is cannot be repeated. If somebody enters the same username, then you should get a reply that the username is already existing here. It means the SQL statement which you have written in the PHP program should say that it is already there is some existing values. The query whatever you entered is failed. So enter username already exists, display name and a blank registration form again. So the registration form again should be shown so that a new username can be entered by the user. So here, as my in my video demos, the earlier video demos, I have shown you the password field. So let me open that previous examples what we discussed here. So where is my WAMP? On the WAMP file, when I'm discussing on the previous videos, so here the password field is not encrypted, rather it is a normal text. So here in my MySite 1 and MySite 2, you can see my previous videos. Like if you see the login page here, so the login page here, the input type is basically a normal text here, which is not encrypted here. But in the exercise, what I am asking you to is use this function MD5, message digest file. Message digest file is a built-in function for encrypting of your passwords that you enter into that text box or that particular password box. So instead of plain text, you can see dot dot dot. So the users who are entering that, or SHA one hash. But whatever the method you enter here, make sure that the same encryption method is followed in your database also. Otherwise, there will be a mismatch here. And also make sure that the password field of the table may no longer be this many number of characters. So you are putting a restriction there. And similarly, you have to make sure that whenever some user is entering more than 40 characters, then your JavaScript validation should say that there is an invalid password is being entered in the registration time, because it cannot be more than 40 characters. So all these features, this because this is an assignment, if you do, it is a wonderful exercise which can complete your task one and task two to maximum extent here. So this username and passwords authentications, if you do it properly, all your major assignments for 30 marks is almost 50% to 60% is over in this assignment itself. So once the registration is completed, then the part three. The part three is basically whatever the registered users are there, and the user should be able to, you need to go to a login form. There's another login form. So in the login form, you need to make sure instead of registration form, you'll have now a new form called as login form to enter the registered users, usernames and passwords. Once they are successful, then otherwise is invalid username or password. And again, the login form should be back. This activity already I've shown in my previous demo of this particular, MySite 1 and MySite 2. The previous two, three demos, please go through it. This particular activity is already completed. So this particular thing. So these things are not very big task, in fact. Very simple task. This part three is entirely completed by me. Part one is also completed. Part one, I have shown you how to create database, how to create table, how do you enter a dummy data. Registration form also, how do you create this one. Authentication I have shown, but I'm asking you to enter a registration form with three fields. Login activities already I have shown you in the video activity. And I'm asking something extra feature here, something, suppose some users will usually forget about their passwords or they lost their passwords. Again, some kind of hints should be given and you can retrieve those passwords for the users. So, or you can reset the password. You have to give a reset button there so that the user can reset the existing password. It means the password should be updated to the new password. So update queries, SQL statement will come into picture here. So please make sure the particular SQL statement is going to enter here. Similarly, the change password form, you want to change the password, you can change those things. So this is the assignment. And create a web page having frames using, see, this is a continuation to assignment 3, question number 6. So in if you see the assignment 3, okay, let me open the assignment 3 once again. So that assignment 3 here, question number 6, if you look here, I ask you to create, this is an extension actually. So these are the different Some people may use table. I have clearly mentioned here using CSS features instead of table. And people say that, sir, can you do with table? Can you do with THTR? Okay, then I said, oh, it's up to you. But what we have to do, if suppose you, when the question is asked for CSS and you want to do with table, you do it. So we will do the evaluation accordingly. That is not a problem. So please make sure the question is clearly given here. You know what is CSS and how to divide this web page into these different sections. I have given you an example also in my previous video class. So using this same concept, only thing is you have to design another web page. So that web page is something like this in the assignment 4. So you'll have something like a heading section here, and the left, this the bottom section is divided into 3 subsections. The left side will have this, the right side will have whatever you select from this here. In the center of this section should be displayed here, and if you want to put some images, put some relevant images here. So the frame, which includes object to person, are the hyperlinks. So you need not put some extra informations, and do not waste your time. Just click the link. Okay, user has clicked the family information. You need not provide that family information here. If the user clicks education information, you just say the user has clicked education information link, then you need not provide your education information links here. Just to make sure that this is very small activity to design a web page in a particular structure. This is one particular structure. If you want to put your information on the website, you can put like this one. Yeah. So this is one question here. And make sure that whenever the links have been clicked, the links has color has to be changed. So how do you change it? There is a, you know what is an anchor tag? Anchor tag will give you that attribute to whenever a user clicks that particular anchor tag, the color changes from blue to green, green to red, whatever the color you like to have it. So that attribute, you need to use it in your anchor tag. So basically your anchor tag gives the set of attributes. So please go through that one. Now coming to question number 3, consider the problem set now. Yes, please.
We don't have to use any PHP or MySQL, just HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and so this design only.
For that particular question, for that question. But case study, which for the above one, the user authentication, user registration, and all, you have to do the PHP, MySQL.
Yes, first question is for the SQL and database also.
SQL database, JavaScript for form validations, all these things comes into picture.
Okay, sir.
హలో సార్, అది ఆన్లైన్ క్లాస్లో ఉన్నాను సార్, నేను కాల్ చేస్తాను సార్ ఒక హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ అయినాక. నేను వస్తాను సార్, 6:00 మాట్లాడతాను సార్. 6:00 పర్లేదు సార్. సో దీస్ థింగ్స్ సెక్యూరిటీ థింగ్, ఈజ్ ఇట్ క్లియర్?
Yes, sir.
So that is what your assignment 4 is all about. So here you can use the cookies. Dollar cookie is going to be the function going to be used there. So you can ask that one. Regarding cancer, the problem student of assignment question, add the following user authentication. See, some is not actually repetition, but it is also not redundant actually, but you need to provide some. Suppose if you do this exercise 3, of that particular assignment, this is like this: display appropriate web pages. So for admin, faculty, students, different web pages should be shown for different types of users. So this is one of the tasks for that particular major task that integrated MTech students are going to do there. So this particular feature also can be easily, you can reuse this feature again into your task. It is not a rework you are going to do over there. Very similar, but little bit of changes will be there in that one. Okay, now coming to this is how to use cookies. This is a small example to use a cookie onto your web pages. Once the user is logged in, that cookie should be remain there. Once it is logged out, the cookie should be destroyed. So there are 2 functions for those cookies. So that we need to use it here. So that's what your assignment 4 is there, right? Is it clear? Those students who are attending this session?
Sir, this question number 3, user authentication, like a user ID and password we have to create, and in that only we have to give the option for either to choose admin, faculty, or students.
You can, when the user registration process is going on, you can say what type of user is there.
Oh.
And in your database also, you need to put one more field here, type of user.
Okay, okay, sir.
Type of user. If you are not maintaining that, what type of user is that person, then how will you know what type of user is in the future correspondence?
Yes, I understand. That means if I'm choosing for the admin, then the another page should open and for the faculty and similarly as the students.
Another page means a page with different hyperlinks and different features.
Yes, yes.
For
sir.
Example, purpose.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, Sagiruddin, okay. You only asked for that assignment 4, right? Okay. So it is completed. Tarun, question is, can we use any of those PDO, MySQL Connect and Object Hunter, like won't be there be any dependency issues? No, no, no. You are already using MySQL underscore connect function, Tarun. Tarun, are you there? Yeah, so I can see you are online. So here MySQL underscore connect function is one, which itself is an API query statements for your. So PDO, PHP data database objects is another type of drivers. So we are using one type is enough. Learn please one type, then let us not confuse all the learners with so many types at present. Okay, is it clear, Tarun? Is he there or not? Yes, sir. We have used in the demo, sir, but I'm using object-oriented one in the assignment. So if you know the language tools, then you can use the features. There is no harm in that one. Because I don't want to confuse all the features by selling that without knowing at least one feature now. Let us not confuse with so many features at a stretch for the beginners and all of them. So you may have learned a little bit, so you know those things. So you whatever things you know, you can incorporate. We are not putting any restriction on those things. You can exhibit those features, no problem. Yeah, Rohan, question is, sir, yeah. I think we don't have reply option for announcements. Okay, in the this particular thing, and I'll just check it out today. And once the session is over, tonight I'll check it and I'll get back to you. I'll see whether students are able to get those reply. Reply is not going to be there, but anyway, you need to check it over there. Okay, that is one thing. And other thing is, yeah, any other doubts, please? So I am online only. Sir, are you online, sir?
Yeah, I'm also here.
Just I will be back in 5 minutes, sir.
Okay.
Venkatesh sir is badly in need of me, something.
Okay. Yeah, right. I'm here.
Just I'll be online only. Just kindly hold on. Kindly carry on.
Okay.
I'm back in 5 minutes.
So in the meanwhile, like, if you guys have any questions on those JDBC servlets, okay, the next videos, you can ask me. Feel free. Sagiruddin, what's that request? So you don't want any new material or what?
Yes, sir. This week I don't want new material.
Because, why?
Because all actually this is a new subject for us and we are not getting the time to do each and every subject. So please, if it's possible, this is my request.
Sagiruddin, to be frank, like these sort of requests can't be entertained, okay? So let me be very frank with you. Because the point is, like, even we have to finish the course within 12 weeks, okay? And we are trying to be as slow as possible so that, like, you guys can catch up with the assignments. But to be frank, If everyone has taken those 3 hours of stipulated time which is required for this course every week until now, you would not have fallen behind. Okay. So actually, whatever the videos which we are putting for that week, those videos should already been covered during that week. Okay. You guys are basically dragging the things too long. I mean, like, the problem is, like, very soon you will be in problem and we will also be in a problem where, like, we can't drag anymore. Say, for example, I can't teach any parts left after the last day of instruction. I can't do it. Okay. So the same way, like, I can't give you extension for any quizzes or like any assignments or like even the final project which you have to do beyond the last instruction day. I mean, that is the university restriction, which I can't do much. Okay. So please try to cope with that. That's all. Okay. Sorry for that. Yes, Tarun. Okay, it is the same thing. Okay. You all are still in PHP and JavaScript. Why? Why? So after that one, like, we have even covered even JDBC, servlets. Okay, so this week, if all things would have been gone properly, we would have finished even servlets and JSP. So unit 3 should have finished. Now how many weeks we are? We are in the 8th week. If we don't finish 3 units in 8 weeks, in the remaining 4 weeks, like, we have to finish the remaining 2 week units. Please understand that. Okay. It's not just we covering the thing. You, as students, like, you should be also covering those videos. For us, why we are putting those videos in those weeks? Yes, I can understand, Arun Dharvat. Okay. So, yeah. To be frank, like, even we have gone through those student phases. I mean, like, how much our time is not sufficient. Yes, but the thing is, like, that's how, like, the curriculums are designed, that you should be able to give certain time for certain courses. Okay. So if there are 3 hours of lectures here, to be frank, like, because of it is asynchronous teaching, we are not even putting videos more than 1 hour. Okay. And if you still say, like, we don't have enough time, I don't have any words. Please understand that. Arun Dharvat, are you clear?
Sir, there is any use of JDBC in this intake, whatever the sir has given us, project, whatever, is there any use of that?
Okay. That's an interesting question. I mean, like, the next assignments, you will be basically doing that one, isn't it? Because right now we have gone through only 4 assignments, okay? For the assignments part, there will be at least 2 or 3 more assignments will be there. So in those things, like, we will have the JDBC part. Now regarding your question that in the final project, like, one of you can basically do it using JDBC, JSP and servlets. Okay. By the way, guys, had I missed anything? I just lost connection for a few seconds. And then, like, now my chat box is completely empty. If any of you have asked a question in the last 1 or 2 minutes, you have to please repeat it. Okay. Okay, thanks for clarifying, Karun. Yeah, Nagendra, you are also back.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Is there any doubts, sir?
Nothing. I clarified all the things. Okay. So they had several doubts. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Usually they say that that's what last class also they are mentioning, no, sir. Lecture is very little and exercises are very far high, so not up to that mark of exercises, the lecture. So the expectations will be like that. So you, I just
we are discussing in open. Okay, of course. The concept is like in asynchronous learning you should not be you cannot go so deep. Okay. The idea is like in a proper discussion lecture.
Students will not understand, sir, that this kind
of
will be they want to understand, that's all. What asynchronous or synchronous,
Yeah, but that is the point. I mean, like, we are bound by university regulations. You see, like, in the last meeting, like, Dean was saying, like, a student body has actually went to the vice chancellor and complained about courses which are being taught synchronously. You see? And this is going to happen. This is going to happen. This semester, the decree is like the courses will be taught asynchronous. Since the university has given the decree, we are following that asynchronous mode. It is better to just stick to that instead of rather getting the problems again. For the students who are listening to this discussion, the reason for being asynchronous is, okay, let me try to explain you a small story, okay? I mean, through some example. The people who will have proper internet connection, proper laptop, we all know that by synchronous learning, you will learn a lot. Okay, so people who will have proper internet connection, proper laptops, you would like to have synchronous lectures. Even we would like to deliver synchronous lectures as teachers. Please understand that. But the problem is, because of the digital divide in India, half of the students, more than half actually, forget about in this class of 80, probably 10, 15 of you have this comfort zone. Rest of the 50, 60, 70 people, they are surviving on mobile networks. So that means in India, most of the mobile networks have a limit of 1.5 gigabytes per day. If 1.5 gigabytes is to be used by that student, okay, a mobile network is to be used in one live lecture, one synchronous lecture, he will eat up that. Then how about the other two or three courses which he should be attending? He can't attend. Okay, so that's why these are generic restrictions which university has to face. That's why like certain rules will be put. So it is better that we just follow them. Okay, so individual courses, if they differ to it, then the bigger goal of why we are doing it will be lost at the university level. Yeah, we can understand this is really, really, really odd semester because of a pandemic which we have not seen in the past 200 or 300 years. Okay, hope everybody is clear, and please carry this message to your friends as well. Agreed? Why nobody has responded? Everybody disagrees. Yeah, now the messages are coming. Thank you. Thanks guys for understanding. Certain things are not in our hands. If we had much more time for courses like WebTech. The problem with almost all the courses is like we only have those stipulated 12 weeks, sorry. In 12 weeks, like the curriculums are to be finished. Whether it is a 3-grade course, whether it is a 4-grade course, whether it is a 5-grade course. In your case, the problem is, of course, I don't know like to which of the curriculum you are in. If it is MCA, then it is only 3 grades, but if it is an integrated MTech, it's 5 grades, okay? And since both these curriculums are joined together and then like thrown into one course, we have to find a balance between the 3 grades and 5-grade course. More or less the curriculum pace at which we are going is around for 4 credit cards. Okay. These are restrictions. Again, the same answer goes. Okay. So certain things are not in our hands. So these are the things which should have been planned during the curriculum design, which must have happened, let's say, for example, some 5-6 years ago. But of course, even during the design of curriculum, they might have given enough thought about it. We should not blame them either. So we have to find a balance. I think we are trying to balance it properly. Okay. So all the integrated M.Tech students basically understand, like, this is a 5-credit course for you. Probably the amount of time you are giving for a 3-credit course, you should almost double for this course. Then things will be proper in simple terms. Okay. Only there is Vivek is there. Neeraj, if you don't have any questions, like, you can leave. There is no restriction, like, you should be there till the 2 hours. Okay. Feel free. We'll not restrict you. But if you want to stay longer, yeah, you are always welcome. We'll be there for 2 hours. నాగేందర్ గారు అందరు వెళ్ళిపోయారు మరద్రమే ఓకే ఓకే క్యారీడ్ క్యారీడ్
హలో సార్, సారీ,
నేను
మాట్లాడుతున్నాను. ఆయనకు ఆయన ఆయన ప్రాబ్లం అయింది.
ఏమిటి?
అది ఇక్కడ ప్రాక్టికల్ గా ఆన్లైన్ చేశాడు సార్. ప్రాక్టికల్ ఆన్లైన్ లో స్టూడెంట్ సబ్మిషన్స్ అవ్వట్లేదు, మూడు సర్వర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ వస్తున్నాయి అని చెప్తున్నారంట. అరే అని చెప్పి నేను ఆయన కోర్స్ కి వెళ్ళి ఆయన స్టూడెంట్ సబ్మిషన్ లిస్ట్ చూస్తే, చూడండి ఇక్కడ మీకు ప్రెసెంట్ నౌకి వెళ్తున్నాను చూడండి స్క్రీన్ లో. అసలు చూడండి, ఈ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఎట్లా చెప్తారంటే ఆన్సర్ వస్తేనే అయినట్టు. అది చిత్రం నాకు అంటే ఏమనాలకు అర్థం కావట్లేదు సార్. ఇప్పుడు చూడండి ఇక్కడ ఇది ఏం చేశాడంటే, ఇది ప్రాక్టికల్ గా చేశాడు. యాక్చువల్గా థియరీ ఫంటాస్టిక్ గా చేశాను, బాగా చేశాను, బ్రహ్మాండంగా చేశాను, షఫలింగ్ చేశాను, క్వశ్చన్స్ అన్ని చేశాను అన్నారు. ప్రాక్టికల్ ఏం చేశారంటే, ఆయన వర్చువల్ ప్రోగ్రామింగ్ ల్యాబ్ యూజ్ చేశారు. ఇక్కడ మైనర్ 1-1, మైనర్ 1-2, మైనర్ 1-3, మైనర్ 1-4, మైనర్ 1-5 చూస్తారు కదా. ఇక్కడ 5 మైనర్స్ క్రియేట్ చేసుకున్నారు. ఇక్కడ అయితే ఇక్కడ క్వశ్చన్ ఇచ్చారు ఆయన, బైసెక్షన్ మెథడ్ మీద ఈ ఫంక్షన్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఇచ్చేసి టెస్ట్ కేసెస్ ఇచ్చారు. ఒక కేసు ఏమో ఇది ఇన్పుట్ ఈ విధంగా ఉండాలి, ఇంకో కేసు కి ఇన్పుట్ ఈ విధంగా ఉండాలి, అవుట్పుట్ ఈ విధంగా రావాలని చెప్పి ఇచ్చారనమాట. స్టూడెంట్స్ సబ్మిషన్ లిస్ట్ చూడండి ఇక్కడ ఎంతమంది, లెఫ్ట్ సైడ్ నెంబర్స్ నువ్వు చూసారా, 1 నుంచి 35 మంది సబ్మిషన్ చేశారు సార్. ఇక్కడ లిస్ట్ చూడండి మీరు, ఒక్కొక్క స్టూడెంట్ ఒకసారి 18, 10, 12,
1
కొన్ని అవైలేట్ కూడా అయినాయి ఆటోమేటిక్ గా. ఆయన టెస్ట్ కేసెస్ పాస్ అయినప్పుడు ఆటోమేటిక్ గా అవైలౌట్ అవుతుంది. అది 5 out of 5 కూడా వచ్చింది. ఒక స్టూడెంట్ 5 out of 5 కూడా వచ్చింది. ఇంకో స్టూడెంట్ కి 5 out of 5 వచ్చింది. ఇక్కడ చూస్తున్నారు కదా మీ స్క్రీన్
కనబడుతుంది.
ఇప్పుడు ఆ పర్టికులర్ ఒక ఫర్ సపోజ్ ఈ ఒక స్టూడెంట్ తీసుకున్నాం అనుకోండి, 14
సబ్మిషన్స్
చూడండి ఇక్కడ. చూడండి 2:46, 3:00 కి, 4:05 కి, 1 అవర్ గ్యాప్ లో అంటే ఆయన సెట్టింగ్స్ కరెక్ట్ గా చేయలేదు యాక్చువల్ గా, మళ్ళీ 5:13 కూడా సబ్మిట్ చేశారు. ఈ సబ్మిషన్స్ ఉన్నాయి అక్కడ, ఆ సబ్మిట్ చేసిన ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇది. ఒక్కొక్క స్టూడెంట్ ఇన్ని టైమ్స్ చేస్తే ఆ స్టూడెంట్స్ అంటున్నారంట మోడల్ సర్వర్ వర్క్ అవట్లేదు అంటున్నారంట. నాకు ఏమనాలి అర్థం, అంటే వాళ్ళకి ఇప్పుడు అక్కడ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయింది, ముగ్గురు స్టూడెంట్స్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయినాయి సార్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్, ఆయన ఇచ్చిన ప్రోగ్రామ్ చూస్తే ఒకళ్ళు ఇది 2, 3, 4 అయినట్టు ఉన్నాయి ఇక్కడ, 4 అయినాయి ఇక్కడ, 35 మంది ఉన్నారు ఇక్కడ, 35 మంది సబ్మిట్ చేశారు.
ఎవరిదైనా చేశారు
కానీ వాళ్ళు సబ్మిట్ కాలేదని చెప్తున్నారంట. ఏం చెప్పాలి, నేనేం చెప్పాలి వాళ్ళకి, నేనేం చేయాలి సార్ దానికి. ఇప్పుడు ఆయనకి ఇది చెప్పాను, ఇక్కడ సబ్మిషన్స్ లో ఉన్నాయి సార్ మొత్తం స్టాటిస్టిక్స్ ఉన్నాయి, ఎవరు సబ్మిట్ చేశారు, వాళ్ళ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ అన్ని ఉన్నాయి ఇక్కడ, సబ్మిట్ చేశారు అవి కూడా ఉన్నాయి ఇక్కడ, మీరు కాలంటర్ చూసుకోండి. వాళ్ళకి ఇగో ఇక్కడ ఫెయిల్ టెస్ట్ కేసెస్ ఇక్కడ ఉన్నాయి, ఫెయిల్ టెస్ట్ అనమాట ఏమేంటనేది, సమ్మరీ ఆఫ్ టెస్ట్ కూడా ఉన్నాయి ఇక్కడ, అన్ని చూసుకోవచ్చు ఇక్కడ. అంటే వాడు రాలేదు, ప్రోగ్రామ్ పాస్ అవ్వలేదు అక్కడ, ప్రోగ్రామ్ పాస్ అవ్వకపోతే రన్ కానట్టు వీళ్ళకి మనీ. అసలు అక్కడ అక్కడ 5 స్టూడెంట్స్ కి అయినా ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ 5 out of 5 వచ్చింది, 2.5 వచ్చింది అక్కడ. మనం ఇప్పుడు ఆల్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్ అయితే, ఇప్పుడు వీళ్ళు సక్సెస్ఫుల్ కాకపోతే, సక్సెస్ అదే అన్న సక్సెస్ఫుల్ కాకపోతే 3 సార్
ముందు ప్రోగ్రామ్ వర్క్ అవ్వలేదు కాదు, 3 సార్ వర్క్ అవ్వలేదు.
అది వాళ్ళ వాళ్ళ క్లెయిమ్, అది మనం ఏం చేస్తాం చెప్పండి.
సరే 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 సరే, ఎక్కువ గవర్నమెంట్కి వెళ్ళండి, వీళ్ళు అంతే అనేసి వదిలేడు మేము. బేసికలీ ఈ రోజు మీరు లేనప్పుడు వీళ్ళు డిస్కషన్ ఏంటి తెలుసిన, ఈ వారం మెటీరియల్ పెట్టకండి ఓకే, ఒకటి ఒంటియే నేను పెడతాను అని చెప్తే నేను
వీళ్ళు ఇంతే సార్
వీళ్ళు
ముందుకెళ్ళు.
మీరు కావాలంటే వీడియోస్ అబ్జర్వ్ చేయండి, నవ్వుతూ నరికేశారు వీళ్ళందరూ మిమ్మల్ని, 5 or 4 or 5 క్వశ్చన్లు అడిగేసి, ఏమో తక్కువ ఏంటి బాగుండు, కోర్స్ కరికులం తక్కువ ఏంటి బాగుండు, ఇంకా మేము పిహెచ్పి చేస్తున్నాం, ఇంకా పిహెచ్పి చేస్తున్నారు రా అంటే వీక్లీ వచ్చి 3 hours లెక్చర్స్ ఉండాలి, మనం మొత్తం కలిపి వీడియోస్ వచ్చి 1 hour కనుక దాటట్లేదు. అయినా మీరు చూడకపోతే ఎవడదు రా తప్పు,
స్టూడెంట్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వ్యూలో వాళ్ళు అట్లానే ఆలోచిస్తారు సార్. స్టూడెంట్ కి ఏంటంటే సొంతంగా చదువుకోవటం అలవాటు లేదు.
అవును, ఈ బాగా స్పూన్ ఫీడింగ్ అలవాటు అయిపోయినాయి.
క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో ఇప్పుడు ఇదే క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో చెప్తే ఆటోమేటిక్గా వర్కౌట్ చేస్తారు సార్, చేసో ఏదో ఒకటి కంప్లీట్ చేసేవాళ్ళు. ఇప్పుడు ఇంట్లో కూర్చొని ఇప్పుడు కంప్యూటర్ ముందు కూర్చొని సొంతంగా చేయాలంటే ఆ ఓపిక ఎనర్జీ రాదు అలాగే,
అంతే
అది వచ్చిన ప్రాబ్లం అంతే సార్.
ఏం లేదండి, జస్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ పేషెన్స్. ఇప్పుడు ఆ రోజు మొన్న వర్చువల్ మెషిన్ క్రాష్ అయింది
సార్,
ఓకే, నా వయసుకి 42 సంవత్సరాలు అప్పుడు నేను పొద్దున్న ఈ రోజు 9 నుంచి రేపు మధ్యాహ్నం 1 గంట వరకు కంటిన్యూస్లీ 36 hours కి అట్లీస్ట్ నా వర్కబుల్ సొల్యూషన్ పూర్తి పని చేయదు, ఏదో